Hey guys, welcome back to Spices and Flavors. Sometime back, I had posted a picture of this beautiful cake on social media platforms and asked you guys whether you would like to have a video tutorial on how to write beautifully on a cake. And with the overwhelming response that I got for this post, I had to make a video on that. Yes, yes, I understand I'm super late at putting out this video tutorial, but better late than never, right? Throughout this video, I'll be sharing certain tips and tricks that would be useful for you guys to master the art of writing on a cake. So without any further ado, let me put a full stop on my chatterbox and now let's see how to write beautifully on a cake. To write on a cake, we definitely need a parchment paper cone or a piping bag, right? So that brings to my tip number one, which is to use a smaller sized parchment cone to write on the cakes. Now, why smaller sized? I find that the smaller the size of your cone, the better your control and grip on the cone would be. And that would ultimately result in a better or a beautiful writing on the cake. So let's first quickly see how to make a parchment paper cone.
To make a parchment cone, we will first start by making a triangle out of the parchment paper. Now, smaller the size of your triangle, the smaller your cone will be. The process of making the triangle is similar to the paper boats that we all must have made in our childhood days. Do not consider this piece of paper as a waste. You can always use this to practice writing. So we now have our triangles ready. Now let me show you how to make a cone out of this. You take the larger side of the triangle. So the top side is our larger side. Using your index finger, hold it at the center and using your other hand, bring one edge to meet the point at the center, like so. The center should meet. It should form a straight line. We already have a tip at the top, if you could see. Now lift it up and bring the other end towards the center to make a straight line out of the three points. Turn it upside down, and if you notice that the tip of the cone is not closed, then twist the papers forming the straight line to make sure that the tip is closed at the bottom. Finally, fold the papers like the way I am showing it to you to make sure that the cone is sealed and does not tear apart while we are working with it. To double sure that it's sturdy enough, make a slit at the center and then fold it one more time. This would make sure that your cone would never come apart.
Now that our cone is ready, we need a medium with which we would write on the cake. For the same, I would recommend or I would suggest you guys to use chocolate. So that's my tip number two, that is to use chocolate as your medium to write on the cake. Now why chocolate? Because chocolate is more viscous, it has more fluidity as compared to buttercream or ganache. That's why it becomes easier to control the fluidity of our chocolate and which helps us to write easily and effortlessly. Of course, you can use ganache or buttercream as your medium, but think of it. We as home bakers won't be having ganache or buttercream at all times at our home, right? So chocolate is one such thing which can be melted quickly, and because of its natural viscosity, it becomes easier for us to write with the help of chocolates. Now that our cone and medium of writing is sorted, let's quickly jump into the technicalities. For which we will have to melt the chocolate first, right? I have already uploaded a detailed video on the right way of melting the chocolate. So I would link that up here or in the description box below. Do have a look because even that has a lot of information.
Let's fill our cone with melted chocolate. This is another tip for you guys, that never fill your cone right to the top, just fill it half. That is because if you fill it more than half, while folding it, it may ooze out from the top. So bring the edges together, fold one edge to the center, other edge to the center. and roll it out to tighten it at the top. So this is where your pressure would be. Make sure the cone is tight enough here.
That brings us to trick number 3, which is to cut your parchment cone to the right size and the proper way of holding it.
As a beginner, I would recommend you to cut the cone as close to the tip as possible and then draw a line onto a parchment paper. See, this is way too thin here. So we will cut our cone little bit more and then again draw a line and see whether it is good enough. Likewise, we will try and test until we reach a point where the chocolate should be thick enough, because when we write on cake, only then would it stand out. After 4 cuts, I find that my chocolate at this stage is perfect to be written on a cake. Now, with practice, you would master it and cut it straight away. Instead of a parchment paper, you can always test it on the cup that you use to melt your chocolate. Never touch your cone to the parchment paper or to the cake. It's not like the way we write with a pen. There should always be at least a minimum of 1 inch gap between your cone and the parchment paper or the cake. Only then you will have a grip or control over the flow of chocolate and you'll be able to guide it properly. The second thing under this tip is that use your index finger as your guide. Place your index finger onto the parchment cone and then you have the flexibility to move it here and there or adjust it or guide your right hand to make sure that the flow and the letter or alphabet that you are intending to write comes out smoothly. So the thing is, you apply pressure at the top center like I showed you in the previous tip, and using your left hand you guide the movement of the chocolate. Leaving some gap between the parchment cone and the parchment paper, start applying pressure using your right hand and using your left hand guide the movement of the chocolate. When you are about to end, release the pressure off and just move the chocolate upwards or in the direction that you want. This is what happens when you do not release the pressure when you are about to end and stop guiding the chocolate. Did you see the trail on the other line? You do not want that, right? Always have a solid pressure on the top. Fold your parchment cone paper whenever needed, making sure that it's perfectly tight. Leaving a gap between the cone and the parchment paper, start applying pressure using your right hand and using your left hand guide the movement of chocolate. And when you are about to finish, just release the pressure and guide the end to give it a neater look.
By now, I'm assuming that you might have got a certain idea about how to hold and how to draw lines. Now let's proceed and see how to make your words or fonts look more stylish and appealing to the eyes. Say for example, if you are writing happy birthday or happy anniversary. So in that case, the first alphabet of the word, which in this case is obviously H, B and A. So these letters should be more prominent, more bigger. So it should be slightly stylish.
And to make it more stylish, use all your calligraphy skills that you might have learned all through your school days and just put out your creativity in there.
So that's how you write the first alphabet, which automatically pops up in the cake and make your eyes go to it. Now that brings us to our next tip, which is how to write the remaining alphabets. Say for example, happy, or say for example, birthday. Let's take an example of birthday. So you have written the first alphabet, which is B, more stylishly, more prominently and little bit bigger in size. To write the remaining alphabets, that is I, R, T, H, D, A, Y, draw an imaginary line onto it and then using that as your guide, you have to write the remaining alphabets.
Let me quickly write birthday and then I will explain you what I was talking about. So if you notice here, let's draw an imaginary line that I was talking about. Like so. So all the alphabets are starting at the same line. Did you notice?
Now what impression does this give as a viewer? It basically makes us feel look more neat, more clean, and looks as if it is professional. And what trick did you do? Nothing, it was so simple, right? Just mix and match the size of the fonts, which automatically grabs the attention. So the next tip that I would like to give is to use a mix of fonts. Now you can of course print it or you can write it in cursive, whichever way you are comfortable with. But just look at this birthday for example. Don't you think the mix of fonts is making it look more appealing? Yes, right? I definitely think so. That might be my personal preference, but I think mixed fonts, that is some printed and some scripted, makes it look even more appealing. What do you guys think? Do you like the plain printed font types or do you enjoy the cursive ones? Comment below and let me know about your preference. So in this case, if you see the birth, B-I-R-T-H, I have written it in the printed font and the D-A-Y in the cursive, making it look more casual, you may say, or making it look more friendly. Automatically, my eyes visions that writing and makes me feel more connected to it. So that was our tip of using a mixed fonts for the same.
And to make your writing look even more professional and stylish, just style your first and last alphabet. Automatically, everything will look good. Draw an imaginary line in your mind, not on the cake, okay? And write according to that. Also use cursive fonts. And to write alphabets like I and J, use a heart-shaped sprinkle to draw the dot in contrast color. That would make your writing even more pop-up.
Like I mentioned, using chocolates is very advantageous. You know why? So take for example this anniversary. I did not like how the way the E or Y turned out to be. So once the chocolate dries out and hardens, you can always remove it off and rewrite. Cool, right? So that was my tips and tricks on how to write on cakes. There's just one last thing that I would like to tell you guys, that is to subscribe to Spices and Flavors. With all these tips and tricks, you might get some idea and some information, but unless you guys practice, I'm sorry to say you won't crack it at the first go on a cake, and you don't want to mess up with your cake, right? So practice a lot. Take a parchment paper and take some melted chocolate and just write and write with these tips that I have shared with you guys. While practicing, there is one more thing that you have to take care, which is to practice it on your cake tins so that you get an idea about the size. I mean, when you use a 6-inch cake tin, the styling or the fonts would be smaller as compared to when you use a 10-inch cake tin. Depending upon your cake, you have to lengthen or shorten your fonts. So that's one more thing that you have to practice. And of course, there is also one more advantage of using chocolate. You can always spread it out on a parchment paper, allow it to cool, and then store it in an airtight container and reuse whenever you want to. That brings us to the end of this video. I hope I did not bore you guys with all my blabbering and you found this video really informative and helpful. If yes, do smash that like button, share it with your friends and family, and subscribe to Spices and Flavors. I'll see you soon with more such breaking related videos and vegetarian recipes. Until then, this is Sushma signing off from Spices and Flavors. Take care. Bye-bye.